You are listening to the Your Empty Nest Coach podcast with Coach Christine, episode number 62, Using Gratitude as a Net. I work with mothers of high school students and beyond who are in the trenches with sad and possibly overwhelming thoughts about what their life will look like when their baby heads to college and begins to leave the nest. My client's big question is, what will I do with my time? Is this you? I've been there and I get it. Empowering you to write the next jaw-dropping, amazing chapter in your life is my passion. I am energized by leading you in the process of exploration and am thrilled when you unlock the power that lies within you. This podcast is my gift to you. Hello, hello, gorgeous lady. How are you doing with your reflection in the mirror? You are beautiful. Do you believe it yet? And those non-resolutions that you might have had. Have you done the thought work needed to allow them to manifest as a reality in your life? How about I ask you another question? I guess that was one, wasn't it? Thanks. Thank you. It's time to thank our sponsor. This episode is sponsored by my community, the Green Popsicle Sticks. Ready to find the GPS of your life? Then sign up for my Thursday Thoughts About email, where you will gain immediate access to the GPS Life Principles document and will receive a link to join our community. And it's all free. See the link in this episode's show notes or head to my website, youremptynestcoach.com, and click the Thursday Thoughts About button to get started. See you there. Hi, my friend. So I'm going to try something totally different today because I'm all about doing things that make me uncomfortable. The title is Using Gratitude as a Net. And I have no script for the actual content right now. So it's more like you're sitting here having coffee with me and we're just chatting. So the topic came to me in November. There's a shocker because in November, the end of November, especially in the United States, there is a lot of talk about gratitude. It's Thanksgiving, and then it's the holidays. And here's the thing, the fact that it needs to be special is a bit disturbing. When we use gratitude every single day and have it in our life, when we're truly present in every moment, I'm talking, you know, someone just yelled at you and you can be present enough to realize that there's a chance you could have no hearing and not even be able to hear them. Do you hear what I'm saying? Like, when you become present and are able to see the details in your life in a way that you couldn't prior, gratitude becomes woven throughout your life as a net, and it is able to lift you up the more you use it. It's almost like the more you use it, the tighter the weave, and you're able to find the positive in your life so much easier. You're able to be more present. And the gratitude will drive you. It will lift you up. When you fall, it will catch you. So how does that sit with you? Are you using gratitude as a net? Do you need Thanksgiving? Do you need a holiday? Do you need reminders for gratitude? Because I challenge you, if you need those reminders, that should be your priority. Really, truly, presence and gratitude and presence. Using gratitude and presence together, create a net that will protect your life every day. Create a barrier of appreciation, gratitude, and love. And then when you simmer in your moments, you'll just have a lovely net, almost like a hammock. I'm picturing this as a hammock right now. See, and now, do you want to have coffee with me? Because you can see where my head goes without a script. Anyway, so let's every single day in our lives, all of us really focus on gratitude. And if you need me to say, hey, think of three things you're grateful for right now in this moment, then do that. There are three things, you know, if you need me, someone else to tell you, think of three things every morning when you wake up that you are grateful for. And then begin to think about it every hour and then every moment. And then use moments of emotional response that you don't like and you catch yourself to use that as a reminder to not only work on your thoughts, which yes, I'm always talking about, but if you can't get to your thoughts, maybe just find three things to be thankful for in that moment and go from there. Let me know how your net is holding you up and let me know how well it's woven. So thankful for you. You truly are a huge part of the weave in the net of my life. So thank you for being here. The questions I have for you in this episode are, how much gratitude is woven into your life? And what are three things right now in this moment that you are grateful for? I invite you to fly on over to our Facebook group to share your answers to these questions with our amazing flock. Our name is Green Popsicle Sticks. Want to know why? Listen to episode number 17 or head to my website, youremptynestcoach.com/community for links to join our flock. We look forward to seeing you there. Thanks. Thank you. A huge shout out to my GPS execs, the executive producers of my podcast. Visit my website or see my show notes for a link to learn how you may become a GPS exec, where you will gain bonus access to me and more. As always, I provide content to make you think, my empty nest friend. My hope is that I am able to provide you with thoughts that positively impact your life. You'll find the show notes for this and every episode on my website, youremptynestcoach.com/P for podcast, and the episode number for this one, it is /P62. Are you able to screenshot this episode right now? If so, take a minute to do that and then share it on social media to help others find it. That would be incredibly helpful. Be sure to tag me at Empty Nest Coach so I may personally thank you. If you enjoyed this episode, I invite you to take a moment to subscribe to this podcast. It is free. And my wonderful empty nest friend, don't you dare forget that you are amazing.